Good, Mr. President. I called that thing Sunday morning when we awakened to go to Mass. I told B, I said, that damn obstruction is back. And that's exactly what it was. There was no evidence of tumors or cancers. It was just a simple adhesion down there.
In other words, as far as your ability to work and everything, like, no question can be raised.
No, they're still doing it. Did it right in the hospital the day after the operation. I brought my executive assistant up and started right away.
Let me ask a couple of other things that have to do with what we signed here. As you probably are aware, what this, if you were to be nominated, and Mr. Clink, of course, talking to John Mitchell on the show, decision-making insofar as the Federal Bureau of Investigation is concerned.
I feel that I would have taken a greater beating had not the Urban Committee been established. And this is always a possibility there that you're not going to get too much flack before judiciary. I think I'm going to take the expected heat from Kennedy, Fry, Hart, Tunney, that group. But I don't think it's going to be nearly as severe as it would have been had not the Urban Committee been established. I think that's where it's all going to hang out, and I'm not ashamed for it to hang out, because I think the administration has done a hell of a fine job in going after this thing, and I think we're prepared to present it in just that light. Now, if you bring somebody else in, you can be attacked as ducking the issue, trying to put a new boy in so he can go up there and say, I didn't have anything to do with this. This happened on Gray's watch. Get him back here and let him talk about it. I think it's a thing we ought to meet head on.
Let me say, what kind of story can you tell? And they say this, that you're just going to think we had a very intensive investigation. We ran down all leads we could talk to last week, and we questioned at very great length the sworn statements. Did you swear and say this
morning? Yes, we did.
From the members of the White House staff, why didn't you question Mr. Haldeman when you say that?
Perfectly good reason we didn't question Mr. Haldeman, because no agent, even the case agent at the lowest level, felt that any trail led to Mr. Haldeman. He did not recommend that a lead be set out to interview Mr. Haldeman. The field supervisor did not. The special agent in charge did not. The bureau supervisor did not.
At least did lead to others.
Did lead to others. And we went out. This is one I had. Sir? Yes, sir. Oh, thank you. Yes, we stand three times. Mitchell once. Bob Haldeman, not at all. I'm not really afraid of that thing, because I called those agents in at the end of that first week and just gave them unshirted hell and told them to go and go with all the venom and vigor possible. I furthermore called Larry O'Brien that Saturday morning, and I said, Mr. O'Brien, I hear there's some rumors around this town that the FBI is not pursuing this with vigor. And he said, no, he said, let me assure you, we are very happy with what you're doing. So I'm going to lay that on their backs. And other things like that. I don't fear that investigation.
What else do you think they will raise? The morale of the bureau and so forth.
Oh, I think they'll do that, but I think we can shoot that down easily, because I've got all kinds of letters from the field that I wouldn't let come to you. I stopped them. They tried to respond to this criticism that morale is bad. It's actually higher than it's ever been in the bureau.
That's what is the situation, for example? You see, you haven't been able to do anything.
Well, I'm not completely ready to buy that, Mr. President. We have done something. I've been wiping people out of there, you know, like the Assyrian on the floe. I wiped out
the whole country. Do we have any question about that? Please, will please come in. Our Time magazine guy says he's got a direct channel to the government.
Well, he probably has. Sandy Smith used to talk to a lot of government bureau, and I won't talk to the SOB anymore because the relationship
is very high.
No, we laid the cards on the table, and that's right. Three times, right. Laid them right out there, gave the same cards to Newsweek, and each one wrote differently, and I just said no more to this clown. And I won't deal with
it. No, that's the one Mark Patty. This is my card.
No,
two minutes. Rick Smith has written stuff that is true right out of the bureau.
No,
right out of the bureau.
The question of how they're getting the interpretation off the 703s or whatever those forms are. Summary forms. 302s.
Yeah. And, because I would say they're false, then I would just say it was fine.
There's some
losing an error. But this is a case where they have true information, and I suppose that I've been somebody from the bureau. I think Peterson's office puts it out.
Mr. President, you have to realize that other people than we get the 302s, and I have put some pretty strong controls on our dissemination and our accounting. And I don't say that it's not possible it can come from the bureau. It is possible.
Well, let me ask you this. For example, when you follow through on the directive, which I understand was given, everybody in the bureau was to take a lie detector test as to whether what part they played in the wiretapping of my plane in 1968.
No, that directive was not given.
Well, it's given now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, what happened there? Who dropped the ball on that?
I don't know that, Mr. President.
That charge has been around, whether it's true or not.
gave me on Bromley Smith, I guess the bloke's name is, and what they were doing on Anna Chenault and how they tried to...
There was a wiretap, there was a phone wiretap for sure, and there was an allegation...
On your plane, sir?
Hoover told me that the Bureau tapped my plane in 1968, and he told Mitchell the same thing. Now, I want everybody in the Bureau who has anything to do with wiretapping at that time questioned and given a lie detector test, not because I'm going through this, but because the allegation has been made and the stars are going to print the story.
Right.
Do you believe you should?
Oh, sure. But I had, you know, I didn't have any directive like that. I had some questions from John Dean about Bromley Smith, Anna Chenault, and
I'm not making the charge, but I do know that that thing has come up. All we do is play it very
I wouldn't put it past him.
I wouldn't put it past Johnson.
No.
We're not trying to do him. But it is very important that it be known in the Star, and I think the Star is working. That be known that that's been investigated, so that we just don't say, well, the Bureau didn't do it. I know the Bureau's sensitivity on that, but are the same people that do wiretapping for the Bureau now, are they the same ones you had 60
years? We think, Mr. President, that if such an order came, it came to Deke DeLoach from Lyndon Johnson. And Deke got it, he gave it.
All right, he used to have a lie detector also. He's out, I know.
Well, I want to,
I'm not going to be in here denying it from here unless the director of the FBI tells me it's been checked. The FBI cannot be above the law on this thing.
Oh, I know it. No, if this was done, we've got to look into it. Even if the allegation is there, we've got to look into it.
Was Scott there in Las Vegas?
No. He was not at, he may have been in the Bureau. I shouldn't answer that.
Who would you put, who do you think would be the fault of either the second man over there?
I think, Mr. President, that my recommendation to you now would be to continue felt. But I think what I've got to do, is, and which I'm in the process of doing, is come up with an overall plan to submit to you, and you and I should discuss that plan.
Well, the only problem you have on felt is that the lines lead very directly behind them. I can't believe it, but they lead right there. And
we've tried to track them.
I don't
have packets, set traps around to see if we can turn something up.
Well, why don't you get in the bubbles and make the charge then?
Well, maybe that's
it. He's not a newsman.
No.
He's a lawyer,
that's right.
For time.
I know who he is, Mr. President.
I know he is,
and I knew the allegations existed, and I think one thing, Mr. President, I would like to say to you, because I believe I must say it to you, those people over there are like little old ladies in tennis shoes, and they've got some of the most vicious vendettas going on. And they're gossiping.
In the
FBI.
In the FBI, for sure.
So the
agents might be hating everybody else. What about this whole Sullivan, good, bad, or indifferent? You bring him back?
I wouldn't bring him back at all. I wouldn't touch him at all. His first words when he came back to Washington, in response to questions from some of the people in the Domestic Intelligence Division as to why he was here, two words, for revenge. Bill Sullivan was a very disappointed man when Hoover put Deke DeLoach in the position as assistant director.
Deke fired him. I mean, Hoover didn't like him.
Didn't like him, and he began attacking Hoover. The guy is too nervous. He's not articulate at all.
Coming back over to Felton. Very, very difficult to have a belt in that position without having that charge period.
I know.
Incidentally, let me say, this is also a direct need to take a lie detector test on it. We're in right to it now. You are going to take a lie detector test, aren't you?
Sure.
Has he ever taken one?
I don't know.
Now, that charge has been made. John, you prepared the questions that have been made. Has he talked to Time Magazine? This and that and the other thing. And he's going to do it. He's going to get the job. That's the way it has to be. You see, the thing is that there's a lack of discipline over there at the present time. And at least that's part of the problem with the morale. That's part of the problem with leaks.
In the FBI, Mr. President?
Sir, this stuff didn't leak when Hoover was there. I've never known of a leak when Hoover was there. I could talk to him in his office about everything. And the reason is that it wasn't because they loved him, but they feared him. have any kind of relationship with the Bureau, which is necessary. Here we can't have any kind of relationship unless we can trust it. And like
sure.
I used to have, and I would expect that the director in the future to have a relationship with Hoover. He'd come in about every month. He'd either have breakfast or he'd come in here. He'd come alone, not with the Attorney General. I talk about things. I used to have him, my contact with him. If it wasn't me, I'd always get that idea. I'd want to designate one person. He'd call in. He'd call in things. Much of it was extremely valuable, and it never leaked out of here, you know, but he was giving me his stuff that he had, and he called him, and that Earth was my contact. Earth will be in the future. You got to have one man that will not talk, so I wouldn't think of having to go to anybody else. I could use Dean, but he's too busy on other things, so I don't know. John, the point is,
Well, just like this comment you...
That's right.
And they're going to throw you out, and then let's
I know that. I agree.
Way to get it through you. See?
Agree. I have no problem with that.
I don't think I've been some people. I was surprised.
I would like to. I wish the one on Whitman would have stuck.
Sure. Sure. If first thing would be hotter type of the earth.